Today we are going to talk about cell physiology. First of all, cell membrane. Cell membranes are composed of phospholipids and proteins. Lipid bilayer, phospholipids have glycerol backbone, which is hydrophilic head, and two fatty acid tails, which are hydrophobic. Lipid soluble substances like oxygen, carbon dioxide, steroid hormones cross cell membrane because they dissolve in lipid bilayer. And water soluble substances, for example sodium chloride, glucose, water, cannot dissolve in lipid bilayer but can cross through water filled channels or pores or by carriers. Now proteins are either integral proteins or peripheral proteins. Integral proteins are embedded in cell membrane through hydrophobic interactions, include ion channels, transport proteins, guanosine 5 triphosphate binding proteins or G protein. Then are peripheral proteins. These are not embedded in plasma membrane, not covalently bound. It is loosely attached by electrostatic interactions. Intercellular connections. Tight junctions or zonula occludens are between epithelial cells. Intercellular pathway for solutes are either tight or impermeable or leaky or permeable. Tight or impermeable in renal distal tubule and leaky in the renal proximal tubule and gallbladder. Gap junctions permit intercellular communications, for example allow current flow and electrical coupling between myocardial cells. Transport across plasma membrane. Simple diffusion. Electrochemical gradient is downhill and it is not carrier mediated. Metabolic energy is not required, so it is called passive, and no sodium gradient. Equation to Meyer diffusion is J is equal to Pa C1 minus C2, where J is flux or flow, P is permeability, A for area. Factors that increase permeability are: number 1, increase oil-water partition coefficient of solute, decrease radius of the solute, and decrease membrane thickness. These all increase permeability. Small hydrophobic solutes, oxygen and carbon dioxide, have highest permeability in lipid membrane. Hydrophilic solutes like sodium and potassium must cross through water-filled channels or pores. Carrier-mediated transport has three types: facilitated diffusion, primary active transport, and secondary active transport. Carrier-mediated transport has following features. It is stereospecific. It means it can distinguish between different isomers of solute like D-isomer and L-isomer of glucose. D-isomer is transported by facilitated diffusion but L-isomer not. Saturation. Increased concentration of solute causing increased transport rate until carriers are saturated. Competition. Structurally related solutes compete for transport sites on carrier molecules, for example glucose and galactose. Next is facilitated diffusion. It is downhill, the electrochemical gradient carrier mediated, and no metabolic energy is required, and there is no sodium gradient. Rapid than simple diffusion and is stereospecific. Example is glucose transport in muscle and adipose cells is by facilitated diffusion. Then is the primary active transport. The electrochemical gradient is uphill and it is carrier mediated. Metabolic energy is required in the form of ATP. It's called active process. Examples include sodium potassium ATPase pump in cell membrane transports sodium from intracellular to extracellular and potassium from extracellular to intracellular compartment. Both sodium and potassium are transported against their electrochemical gradient. Specific inhibitors of sodium potassium ATPase are cardiac glycosides like digitalis and obain. Calcium ATPase pump in sarcoplasmic reticulum or cell membrane. Sarcoplasmic reticulum or endoplasmic reticulum calcium ATPase is called SARCA. Hydrogen potassium ATPase or proton pump in gastric parietal cells. Now secondary active transport. Two or more solutes transports is coupled in secondary active transport. One of the solute is transported downhill and provides energy for the uphill transport of the other solute. Metabolic energy not provided directly but indirectly from sodium gradient. If solutes move in the same direction, then it is called co-transport or same port. For example, sodium potassium 2 chloride in renal thick ascending limb and sodium glucose for transport in small intestine and proximal convoluted tubule. If solutes move in the opposite direction, then it is called counter transport exchange or antiport. For example, sodium calcium exchange or sodium hydrogen exchange. Now osmosis. We will talk about osmolarity, osmosis and osmotic pressure. First of all, osmolarity. It is the concentration of osmotically active particles in a solution. It is a colligative property and is calculated by osmolarity is equal to G into C, where osmolarity is concentration of particles, G is equal to number of particles in solution, like G NaCl is 2 and G glucose is 1, C for concentration. Isosmotic: if two solutions have the same calculated osmolarity, it is called isosmotic solution. Hyperosmotic: if two solutions have different osmolarities, the solution with higher osmolarity is called hyperosmotic. Solution with lower osmolarity is called hyposmotic. Osmosis and osmotic pressure: osmosis is flow of water across a semi-permeable membrane from a solution with low solute concentration to a solution with high solute concentration. Osmotic pressure difference across the membrane causes water to flow from solution 2 to solution 1 as shown in the figure. Solution 1 has the solute and the higher osmotic pressure. Calculation of osmotic pressure by Van't Hoff law: it is stated that osmotic pressure depends on the concentration of osmotically active particles. The osmotic pressure increases when solute concentration increases. More solute concentration, more osmotic pressure. Higher the osmotic pressure of a solution, greater the water flow into it. Colloid osmotic pressure or oncotic pressure is the osmotic pressure created by proteins like plasma proteins. What is reflection coefficient? It is a number between 0 and 1 that describes the ease with which a solute permeates a membrane. If reflection coefficient is 1, solute is impermeable, creates an osmotic pressure causing water flow, for example serum albumin. If it is 0, solute is completely permeable, not exert any osmotic pressure, for example urea. Calculation of effective osmotic pressure: it is the osmotic pressure calculated by Van't Hoff law multiplied by reflection coefficient. Now, diffusion potential, resting membrane potential and action potential. We will talk about ion channels, diffusion and equilibrium potential, driving force, current flow, resting membrane potential at the end, action potential. Now, first of all, ion channels. Ion channels are integral proteins that span the membrane. Ion channels are selective. Selectivity is based on size of channel and distribution of charges that line it. Ion channels are open or closed. When open, selective ions can flow through it, and when closed, ions cannot flow through. Conductance of a channel depends on probability that the channel is open. Higher the probability, higher the conductance that channel is open. Opening and closing of a channel is controlled by gates. Voltage-gated channels are opened or closed by changes in membrane potential. Activation gate of sodium channel in nerve is opened by depolarization. When open, it permeable to sodium. Inactivation gate of sodium channel is closed by depolarization. Nerve membrane is impermeable to sodium during repolarization phase of nerve action potential. Ligand gated channels are opened or closed by hormones or second messengers or neurotransmitters. For example, nicotinic receptors for acetylcholine at motor end plate is an ion channel that opens when acetylcholine binds to it, and it permeable to sodium causing depolarization. Now, diffusion and equilibrium potential. Diffusion potential is the potential difference generated across a membrane because of a concentration difference of an ion, only generated if membrane is permeable to ion. Now, what is equilibrium potential? It is a potential difference that would exactly balance or oppose the tendency for diffusion down a concentration difference. Nernst equation is used to calculate the equilibrium potential. This equation tells that at what potential would be the ion be at electrochemical equilibrium. Approximate values for equilibrium potentials in nerve and muscle include: equilibrium potential for sodium is 65 mV and for calcium is plus 120 mV, potassium minus 85 mV and for chloride is minus 85 mV. Now, driving force and current flow. Driving force on an ion is the difference between the actual membrane potential and the ion's equilibrium potential. Current flow: it occurs if there is a driving force on the ion and the membrane is permeable to ion. What is resting membrane potential? Resting membrane potential is measured potential difference across the cell membrane in millivolts. It results of high resting conductance of potassium, expressed as intracellular potential relative to the extracellular potential. Thus, a resting membrane potential of minus 70 millivolt means 70 millivolt cell negative. For example, resting membrane potential of nerve is minus 70 millivolt, which is close to the calculated potassium equilibrium potential of minus 85, but far from calculated sodium potential. Now, action potential. Action potential is defined as the electrochemical changes occurring in cell membrane of excitable cells in which rapidly propagates. Now, here are few terms: depolarization, hyperpolarization, inward current and action potential, and threshold potential. Depolarization makes the membrane potential less negative. Hyperpolarization makes the membrane potential more negative. Inward current is the flow of positive charge into the cell. Outward current is flow of positive charge out of the cell. Threshold is the membrane potential at which the action potential is inevitable. Ionic basis of the nerve action potential. Resting membrane potential is the approximately minus 70 millivolt cell negative is the result of high resting conductance of potassium. At rest, sodium channels are closed and sodium conductance is low. Now, upstroke of the action potential. Inward current depolarizes the membrane potential to threshold. Depolarization causes rapid opening of the activation gates of sodium channels and sodium conductance of the membrane promptly increases. The sodium conductance becomes higher than the potassium conductance, and the membrane potential is driven toward the sodium equilibrium potential of positive 65 millivolt. Repolarization of the action potential. It opens potassium channels and increases the potassium conductance to even higher level than rest. Tetraethyl ammonium blocks these voltage-gated potassium channels. The combined effect of closing the sodium channels and greater opening of potassium channels makes the potassium conductance higher than the sodium conductance, and the membrane potential is repolarized. Thus, repolarization is caused by an outward potassium current, while rapid depolarization during the upstroke is caused by inward sodium current. Then is the hyperpolarization after potential. Potassium conductance remains higher than at rest for some time after closure of the sodium channels. During this period, the membrane potential is driven very close to the potassium equilibrium potential.